buzzards will not be seen tonight, so that we may bring you the following episode of Almost Live. It's Almost Live with me, Pat Cashman, Tracy Conway, Bob Nelson, Bill Stanton, Nancy Guppy, Steve Wilson, and Ed Wyatt, and starring John Keister. And we've got an exciting show tonight.
That's what I hear.
You don't sound that excited.
I have trouble expressing my emotions.
Well, why don't you give a whoopee or something?
Whoopee.
That's not really much, is it?
Uh-uh.
How about a bigger yell?
Whoopee.
That's still not doing it.
You have a hammer I could borrow?
Yeah, here you go.
Thanks.
That's the stuff. People are excited tonight because here he is.
John.
Keister.
Thank you. Oh, boy. So, I'm so happy to be in Seattle this week because the president cut quite a swath, cut quite a swath through this town this week. He was up in Everett, you might have seen this, giving a speech at the 747 plant, and a special thing happened. I know you know what I'm talking about. You probably read that a Boeing worker asked Clinton for a favor. You guys all see this. Could you help my son get into the Job Corps? And with all the stuff happening in Bosnia and Somalia, he took the time out to make a phone call, and now this kid named Josh is going to learn how to be a cook in Moses Lake, which I think is, that's progress. So I don't want anybody to say that the Clinton administration hasn't accomplished anything yet. So that's, I'm sure if Josh, if he gets a restaurant, he'll name his first sandwich the Clinton or something like that. That, of course, was the most publicized request. But in fact, a lot of other people asked the president for little favors while he was here in town. And we thought you might be interested in the requests. For example, the staff of Cairo News asked Clinton to walk around a lot during the speech for no reason. Which is good. Roger Anderson of the Seattle Times Seen, Heard, Said column asked the president, could you please get him into a good writing program? Two deadheads asked for a ride to Eugene, which is pretty standard. King sportscaster Drew Soitcher asked, would the president start calling himself Bill Clinton? A Blanchett High School student asked, would he please buy a world's finest chocolate bar? Some guys from the Ave asked, can we stage dive during the speech? And finally, the Portland Trailblazers asked for Chelsea's phone number, which I think is... which is a sick joke. But we have to do it. Clinton, he's here, he's all over the country because he wants to talk directly to the people. And he's proven that he's a master of the new world of television. And very soon, they say, we're going to have over 500 channels to choose from. And which means a lot more of those reality video shows are going to be all over the place. And right now, we're proud to present the premiere of a new show that we know will be a huge hit of the future. Take a look. It's time for the wackiest show on television, America's Funniest Most Wanted. Well, welcome back to America's Funniest Most Wanted, the show that keeps them laughing all the way to the bank. You don't believe me? Well, take a look at what the security camera saw at the First National Bank last Tuesday.
He's holding up the bank, but what's holding up his pants? Not much. Now he's really mad.
Well, maybe he can buy a belt with that money, huh? And speaking of keeping your pants up, the working girls are walking the street looking for you, and the police surveillance cameras are looking at them.
Hey, big boy. Think you could fall for a girl like me? I could fall for you.
Enjoyed her trip. Well, now, you've heard of married to the mob, but how about buried by the mob? That's what's going to happen to these guys from messing up so bad.
This guy's got a very important delivery, if you know what I mean. There he goes. Dun, dun, dun. And here comes the pickup man. And now there's spare change all over the sidewalk. How's that for a handout?
I think it's time to ask ourselves, what are the three rules of stealing a car? Number one, don't steal a Pacer. Number two, don't ask the police for directions. And number three, don't do what Robert Anderson of Joliet, Illinois did.
Here's the master car thief at work. He brings the proper tools. He looks both ways to make sure no one's watching, but the one place he didn't look was inside the car. Wow, talk about a headache.
Well, that's it for America's Funniest Most Wanted. And remember, if you see any of these people, don't approach them yourself. They're armed and dangerous. And besides, you might die laughing. All right, we've got a better show than that, so stay with us. We'll be right back.
Promotional consideration for Almost Live provided by Ballard Computer in Seattle, Kirkland, and now open in Tacoma.
Toys, the show for men who want the most out of life because he who dies with the most toys win. I'm Dave, and this is the Party to the Max crew, Kurt and the Craigmeister, and together we have more toys than anybody, so I guess we win. And all I have to say is don't try to change us, babes. All right. Now, let's get to the new toys, and we have quite an assortment this week. First up, if you're like me, you think your stereo looks pretty darn cool, except for one thing. Not enough knobs. They never put enough knobs to make it look really cool, but that's no longer a problem with the new knob extender. Now, this adds knobs instantly. Is this cool or what, huh? All right, next up, a power squirt gun with a laser sight. Now, this is precise up to 50 yards. This is my own design. I tried it out in the park yesterday, and there was a kid who was watching me there, and he had this expression on his face. Like he knew that I had the best squirt gun in the world. Cool. And I love that. I love that, man. All right, next, rollerblades with spoilers. All right. Now, you get this on your shoe, and you will be the fastest blade on the sidewalk, my friend. All right, now, the best new personalized license plate of the week is in. Check this out. Okay, we saw this the other day. Blue Bayou. All right. Whoever thought that up, that was great. All right. Now, for bigger and wilder toys, my partner Kurt tells me there's something new on the jet ski scene. Kurt.
Yeah, right, Dave. The new XL320 from Suzuki, man, is awesome. I mean, it's got power and maneuverability, and it seats too, so the chicks, they really dig it, man.
Whoa. I mean, what do chicks have to do with it?
Well, I'm not saying that.
No, look, it's either awesome or it isn't, okay? Whether chicks dig it has nothing to do with its awesomeness, all right?
Yeah, but it'd be okay to take an awesome babe riding in it, wouldn't it?
Hey, listen, you can't ride balls to the wall with a babe hanging on to you.
Come on, Dave.
Hey, my partner, remember our motto, don't try to change me, babe. Now, how long do you think you'll be skiing if you let a babe ride next to you? Next weekend, she'll have you eating brunch and going to garage sales. Come on, you gotta stay stoked. You have to stay stoked.
Yeah, but I mean, do us guys have to spend every weekend together, Dave?
No. Oh, no, no. Not if you don't want to go work for the record that we have been working towards. Look, why don't you just chill for a while I talk to the Craigmeister? Now, Craig, my man, I know you're going to get a jet ski, aren't you?
I can't, Dave. I don't even have a place for my sailboard.
No, I told you. You put the sailboard under the bed.
That's where the Playboy collection is.
No, 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 no. Look, here's what you do. You take the Playboys out and you put them in those really cool binders with the bunny heads, man.
It scares chicks when you have that many Playboys.
What do chicks have to do with it? You think chicks are gonna help us jet ski to the islands for the go-kart and fireworks festival this weekend? Huh?
You wanna tell them?
No, you.
Well, what are you talking about? Tell me what?
Craig and I met some girls at the bike shop, and we're not going to be going with you this weekend.
Oh, that is great. So you guys turn out to be just as whipped as
the
others. No,
we're not.
Just as whipped as my other so-called partners, Alan and Ron and Clark. Oh, I'm glad you're going. I'm glad you guys, you wussies. I'm glad you wusses are going. You're just as... All right, Jason, come on. You're not whipped, are you, Jason?
No.
No, you're not. All right. Come on. Join us next week as Jason and I report from the awesome festival that all the whipped wusses are gonna miss. All right, come on.
Amplification for Almost Live provided by American Music.
Come on, man, where's my Pepsi?
The key? Oh, shoot. Sorry.
It's no big. You hungry?
Uh-huh.
I'm making baked potatoes.
Oh.
Are you okay?
Why?
Well, I thought I heard a tone.
No, there's no tone.
You sure?
No tone, really.
So how was your day?
Good. Long, but good. A good long day. There's no tone.
I believe you. You want sour cream or butter?
Can I have both?
Yeah, if you want.
No.
What one then?
Whatever.
Honey, just decide, okay?
I don't want to have your keys. Just butter. Butter. Just butter.
You don't want my keys?
Don't be upset.
No, no.
I know we decided and everything.
No, it's okay.
It's not you. It's the keys. They just make me tense.
Oh, God, I can't believe it.
You're upset.
No, God, no. It's just, I've been thinking the same thing, you know, but I didn't want you to be upset, so I didn't say anything.
You've been thinking the same thing?
Oh, yeah, the keys are a bad idea, really.
But you wanted to do it.
Oh, I know, but, you know, you and me, we're just... We're not there. You know what I mean? And that's okay. I mean, we may never be. Anyway, it doesn't matter. I'm just really, really glad you said something. It's a relief. I feel relieved. I do.
Relieved.
Oh, yeah, I do. Don't you?
Yeah, relieved. Definitely relieved.
Good.
Great.
So we're both relieved.
Yes, indeedy.
Okay, well, should we eat?
Let's see.
Okay. Just butter, right? Right?
Are you seeing someone?
No, it's not.
You know, I heard a tone.
There's no tone.
I know a tone when I hear a tone, and I definitely heard a tone.
There was no tone.
Just admit it.
I am not going to admit there was a tone when there wasn't a tone.
I distinctly heard a tone.
If you heard a tone, it was in your head because there wasn't a tone.
Yes, there was.
Stop it. There was no tone, period. No tone.
There's onion on my potato.
I know. I put it there.
I don't like onions.
Well, then take them off.
I've never liked onions. You knew that.
Well, I guess I forgot. Sorry.
Oh, you forgot.
What does that mean?
It means you've mixed us up.
Who?
Me and Tone Man.
Oh.
I bet Tone Man loves onions. I bet he eats them on everything.
No, Tone Man does not love... Look, there is no Tone Man. I am not seeing a Tone Man.
Then why don't you want me to have your keys?
Oh, okay. You're the one who doesn't want my keys. It was your idea. You brought it up.
Don't change the subject.
Oh, this is so stupid.
And for your information, I'm keeping your keys.
You're insane.
No, I've changed my mind. It's a free country, or maybe you haven't heard that. What's the matter? Feeling guilty?
Please shut up.
Afraid I might walk in on you and Tone Man?
Just your potato.
Hey, where's my sour cream? I said I wanted both.
Oh, God. You need a lot of help.
Good evening and welcome to the John Report. I'm John. Here's my report. Seattle Sonic Gary Payton was robbed at gunpoint of $60,000 worth of cash and jewels. Coincidentally, the Gary Payton of poultry was held up for 3 breasts, 2 wings, and a neck. Linwood residents say pigeons are causing problems along Highway 99. Apparently, the birds have been nesting on the side of the road, making it difficult for cars to pull over and pick up prostitutes. At the Seattle Mariners spring training camp this week in Arizona, manager Lou Piniella told his team that this year he was giving them the green light to run. The team was last seen sprinting at full speed just outside of Tucson. A state representative is sponsoring a bill which would make it legal to use roadkill, such as deer and elk, for food. In anticipation of the bill, McDonald's test kitchens are busy working on a recipe for McPossum. An album called Grunge Light has just been released, cashing in on the Seattle music scene with easy listening versions of grunge songs. Exercise guru Richard Simmons has also jumped on the grunge bandwagon with his new record, Sweating to the Music of Skinny-Assed Heroin Addicts. At midnight tonight, Burien officially becomes a city. The celebration will include planes flying over the area constantly for the next 100 years or so. The Seattle Kennel Club All-Breed Dog Show is being held this weekend at the Seattle Center. In today's competition, prizes in the category for Best Working Dog went to a German Shepherd from Auburn, and Best Working Bitch to a Clinique Counter Girl from Bellevue Square. The City of Federal Way announced that it will celebrate its third birthday with a performance by the Federal Way Philharmonic. They later said that announcement was a mistake and that the performance will actually be held by a guy named Phil who plays the harmonica. Finally, Hillary Clinton says imaginary talks with Eleanor Roosevelt helped her get through the stress of last year's campaign. President Clinton says that what did it for him was fantasized sex with Jackie Kennedy. This has been the John Report. Thank you.
This is the sound of... I'm
What's on that sandwich? Is that meat? I really don't want any meat. Could you take that off? Yeah, put some of that stuff on. No, that stuff over there, right by your finger. Does that have meat in it? Okay. And also, I don't want any lettuce. I'd rather have sprouts because I don't really... In fact, why don't you take the sprouts off, put some mayo back on, and just... Would you just start the whole sandwich over, actually? And have you washed your hands?
You have reached the phone mail system. The person you called is either away from the desk, on the phone, or has specifically blocked any calls from your phone because he doesn't want to talk to you. Press 1 to leave a message. Press 2 for other options. You have pressed 2 for other options. Well, you could kill yourself. No, I'm just kidding. Let's see, what could we do? We could transfer you to Kathy the receptionist, but she's kind of a bitch. We'll let you decide. Press 1 if you would like to leave a message. Press 2 if you would like to talk to Kathy the bitch. You have pressed 2, indicating you would like to talk to Kathy the bitch. Wow, you must be really hard up for entertainment. Okay, here goes.
Hi, this is the phone mail for Kathy. Kathy's in a bad mood right now and doesn't feel like answering calls. Press 1 to leave a message. I said press 1 to leave a message. I never said you could press any other numbers. Stop that. Okay? Kathy says you're an ass and to go to hell.
We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.